Skybox Security is a solution that allows you to manage and prioritize your vulnerabilities, ensuring that you're always focused on the most important risks to you and your organization. The key is to understand the infrastructure in detail, whilst providing rich context to each threat situation. In this video, I'd like to take you a bit deeper into our solution, and I'll show you how this works in practice. I'll simplify this by focusing on a smaller environment to help us get started. Let's take a look together and let me show you. For this example, I've set up a small lab environment with a couple of firewalls that are connected to a WAN. Behind each of these firewalls is a web server, publishing a web page out to the internet. At this point, both firewalls and servers have the exact same configuration and firewall policies allowing traffic. The first thing Skybox is going to do is collect all of the configurations from our environment. We do this using our task method, where some tasks are set up to collect the different configurations from across our environment, and others are used to further model and analyze the collected data. Here you can see that we have collected information from both our firewalls and the servers from our lab environment example. Skybox collects all relevant information that is key to the exposure calculation. If we take a closer look at the data from this firewall, we will see the configuration data relating to the network interfaces, routing tables, and even ACLs that are currently in use that are allowing access to one of our web servers. Skybox will not only collect information from the different network or security device sources, but also from assets including servers, workstations, or even OT devices. As you can see from this server, we will also collect information relating to the network, as well as being able to retrieve further contextual information about services running, patches installed, and perhaps most importantly, any vulnerabilities on this asset. These vulnerabilities can be discovered by ingesting third-party scanner results or by using our very own vulnerability dictionary and threat intelligence, or indeed a combination of both. In our example here, let's say a hacker wants to attack from the internet. How would I know if my servers are really exposed? Well, Skybox can automate this analysis through an attack simulation. By analyzing the model that we generated using the collected configurations, we can accurately calculate the level of exposure and therefore fully understand the risk of an attack. So let's see what information we have. As you can see, here we have the same Apache vulnerability detected for both Web Server 1 and Web Server 2. Let's say it's a critical vulnerability because it has a CVSS score of 9.8 out of 10. But the most important thing here is that we know that it is directly exposed to the internet, because there's an open communication path and policies in our firewalls that are allowing it. That's why in Skybox, both vulnerabilities are marked as critical, and therefore a fix should be applied with equal urgency as a matter of priority. If we go into the details of these two active threats, we can get more information about the type of vulnerability, in this case for Apache, and whether it's exposed to a potential attacker. Through our integrated threat intelligence provided by our threat intelligence team, we can also find out if there are any known exploits out there in the wild, thus increasing or decreasing the overall risk score. Here we can see some examples of the known exploits shown here. So let's see this in action now and work through some examples. I'm going to simulate an attacker located on the internet. And remember, according to the information returned by Skybox, both of our servers have critical vulnerabilities and are both exposed to the internet. First, let's see if this is true. To do this, I'll first check to see if I can access both servers from a browser. As you can see, there's no problem at all for Web Server 1 and neither for Web Server 2. Remember that both servers are sitting behind different firewalls. We have our hacker located on our WAN or on the internet. Let's see which versions of Apache are running on our servers. Here we can see that both servers are running vulnerable version of Apache. Well, let's use one of the exploits that Skybox showed us earlier and see what happens if we run it. We can see that our target web server 1 is actually vulnerable. To check this, we can display the content of the file inside the server. Since both servers are vulnerable, according to our analysis, we can perform the same test on web server 2. As you can see, we also have success. But what if I change the topology? What if I add a rule to my firewall that will block access to web server 1? Well, let's see what happens. In the current configuration, I have a rule that allows HTTP or HTTPS access to my web server. Let's change that to a deny rule. Now the situation has changed. We no longer have the same configuration on both firewalls. Now let's take a look at the results of the same test after reanalyzing the model. As you can see now, the results have changed. Web server 1 is no longer accessible from the internet, and therefore to the threat of our supposed hacker. So currently I now only have one threat exposed. If we look at the risk score, we can see that this is now different also, as the context surrounding it has changed. Let's look at the topology now. Skybox allows us to do offline path analysis. We will analyze the route that our hacker is following, in this case first, from our WAN or internet network to our web server one. Since we have modified a rule on our firewall, Skybox shows us that access to the internet to our web server is currently not possible. If we make the same query again, but this time to our web server two, we will see that yes, we have partial access due to the rules of our other firewall, which is exposing this vulnerability. Well, let's see what that looks like now, shall we? If we launch the same attack again on the inaccessible server, we will see that we don't succeed. This is because the rule we modified is denying traffic. In the real world, this would be like using a sledgehammer to crack a nut. I can't base my mitigation strategy on taking down an entire application, but it helps to understand exposure in this example. Fortunately, Skybox offers a variety of solutions that can help mitigate these risks in the real world. For this specific example, we can take a look at the different solutions proposed, ranging from upgrading our Apache to a higher version or applying a specific IPS signature for our environment. Let's see what happens if I apply it. In this case, I look for the proposed reference for my firewall solution. As you can see, it matches the problem I want to solve. Once I've located the signature, I modify my rule to apply the security policies and prevent the exploit. This simply is another way to mitigate the problem. Once the changes have been applied, I just need to collect the data again, analyze it, and review the results in exactly the same way as I did before. Now what we can see is that Web Server 2 is protected because of the IPS signature we just applied. Our Web Server 1, however, is still exposed due to the permissive firewall rules that we have configured. So of course, the main threat I face will be from Web Server 1. You'll see now that I have a higher risk score and therefore can prioritize accordingly. But let's not get too complacent here. Let's see if we can breach Web Server 2, even if it appears to be protected. First, let's check if we can access the web from our hacker's network. As we can see, there's no problem. So now let's test our exploit. If we launch the attack again, we can see that we are unsuccessful. This case is different from the previous one because now we have not blocked the traffic. In fact, we still have access to the website. So let's see what happened in our firewall. The traffic flow shows that the communication has taken place in the network. If we take a look at the threat logs, here we can see that our attack has been blocked. If we dig into the details, we can see that this has been produced from our hacker's IP and that has been mitigated with the signature proposed by Skybox. Obviously, the example we've seen here corresponds to a small, confined lab, which might seem simple, but what if I apply that to a larger real-world environment? You know, there can be hundreds and thousands of threats that can affect my infrastructure every single day, and managing them can be impossible. That's why I need to know where to focus my attention and prioritize what might genuinely be critical threats and risks. Skybox allows you to automate the analysis process and carry out that real exposure calculation, whether in simple or complex infrastructures, to focus on what really matters to you and your organization.